Antibiotic-resistant bacteria is already a growing problem, but is the food we eat making it worse? Hey everyone, Amy with you on DNews today. Every vegetarian has their own reason for going meatless. For me, meat's just too chewy. For others, the drugs farmers feed livestock might be behind their rationale to go meatless. And this is actually something meat eaters should know about too. According to the Food and Drug Administration, antibiotic use by the meat industry is on the rise. The most recent FDA report said the amount of antibiotics sold to farmers and ranchers for administration to livestock has gone up by 20% between 2009 and 2013. Why is this a problem, you ask? For the most part, human antibiotics are administered to animals that aren't sick. Livestock destined for your grocery store don't exactly live in spa-like conditions. These animals are often crammed together in cages or pens that aren't the cleanest, which means they can get sick and might not grow to a healthy size. It would make sense that improving living conditions would yield healthier, bigger animals, but that costs money, and drugs are a cheaper option. Human antibiotics added to animal food and water supplies can help them grow as much as 3% larger than they normally would, which is significant in an industry where the product is sold by the pound. And while this might be good news for farmers, it's pretty bad for the rest of us, particularly those among us who eat meat. Giving healthy animals antibiotics kills off weaker bacteria and creates a perfect environment for antibiotic-resistant bacteria to grow and thrive. Those bacteria travel to us, the consumers, directly in the meat or indirectly on the hands of workers who may be exposed to the antibiotic-resistant bacteria-rich meat. If you eat undercooked meat where those antibiotic-resistant bacteria are present, you could get sick with a bacteria that an antibiotic can't treat. The CDC says around 2 million Americans get infected with antibiotic-resistant bacteria every year, and at least 23,000 people die from those infections. According to Pew Charitable Trusts, the U.S. uses far more antibiotics in livestock than other nations. Norway and Denmark use about 6 times less antibiotics raising their animals. Feeding antibiotics to animals is illegal in Canada and a number of European Union nations. A federal policy was put in place last year that would force drug manufacturers to label their products as unfit for animal consumption unless prescribed by a veterinarian. But this policy didn't address a major loophole. Farmers can argue that they're feeding their livestock drugs to prevent illness, which is an effect of the antibiotics in the animal's food supply. The meat industry doesn't publicize figures about drug usage in livestock, so it's hard to say just how much antibiotics make it into our food supply. But according to a study published in the Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences, more than 63,000 tons of antibiotics were used by livestock farmers in 2010. Researchers expect that number to rise by 67% by 2030. On the other hand, some companies are beginning to cull or even eliminate the use of human antibiotics in animals. Recently, McDonald's announced it was planning to phase out antibiotic-fed chicken in its U.S. restaurants. Chipotle and Panera have been offering antibiotic-free meat for a while now, but in the meantime, it's still a legal practice in the United States. If you want to know more about antibiotic resistance and the search for a cure, check out this episode of Seeker Stories that follows a team of researchers to the bottom of the ocean.
You say it's a crisis. I mean, if you had to rate it on a scale of 1 to 10, where are we at on the antibiotic crisis?
11. It's very serious. We are about to return to a pre-antibiotic era, where even basic surgeries and other medical procedures can lead to death by septicemia and other untreatable bacterial pathogens.
And if you're on mobile, we've got a link to that video down below. So what do you guys think? Are you worried about antibiotics in your meat? Let us know in the comments below, or you can find me on Twitter as AST Vintage Space. And don't forget to subscribe for more DNews every day of the week.